Hi dear students, welcome to Geeta's classes. Now we are going to see, we are going to revise the first unit of Kasam. I think enough revision is done, but still last minute some tips I can give you. You can expect which kind of questions you can, you have to concentrate more, like that we'll discuss. So in the first one, unit one, even unit 1 we have discussed with the revised with the mind map also. You can just go through, you will get all the topics whatever you have to study from there. Okay, so in that case you have to find out, your first you have to study the basic definitions. You have to concentrate more on the definitions. Even at 1 mark, 2 marks questions you can expect definitions also. Like what is a sample space, mutually exclusive. These are all the definitions you have to study. Sample space, mutually exclusive events, and equally likely events. Independent events. Like this, and so many definitions are there, small definitions. You please go through all the definitions once. Okay, and we have defined the probability also. We have given 3 definitions for probability. One is classical, and another one is empirical definition of probability. Empirical probability, then subjective probability. Okay, classical probability, empirical probability, and subjective probability. All these definitions are available. I'm not going into detail because we have to do 5 units revision. And one more thing, mind map, in the mind map revision first 2 unit, I have given all the definitions in detail. Okay, you can just go through that. Okay, that's why I'm not doing all these things in details now. Then next is axioms of probability is there. Definitions of probability, basic definitions, and definitions of probability also you have to study. 3 definitions are there. You please go through that. Then axioms of probability. 3 axioms I have given. Axiom 1, 2, 3. Okay, if it satisfies, if any function satisfies this axiom, then we say that it is a probability function. Then you have to study additive theorem. What is there in additive theorem? P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B, right? Similarly, P of A union B union C is equal to P of A plus P of B plus P of C minus P of A intersection B minus P of B intersection C minus P of A intersection B plus P of A intersection B intersection C. I have given you the clue. You have to start from positive when you are taking one at a time. Start from positive. Write all the variables one at a time. Then negative 2 at a time. Then alternatively positive and negative. So for one single variable it is 1 at a time, it is positive, and 2 at a time negative, then 3 at a time positive, and so on. Okay, that is 3 for 3 variables also you can, it can be extended. Then next is conditional probability. You can expect one definite question from conditional probability and product rule. Okay, conditional probability and product rule or multiplicative rule. Conditional probability we have seen already. P of A given B is equal to P of A intersection B divided by whatever is there after given, you have to write in the denominator P of B. Okay. Similarly, P of B given A also can be defined. And from this only you are dividing the product rule, that is P of A intersection B is equal to P of B into P of A given B. And if they are independent, A and B are independent, this will become P of B into P of A. Okay. Similarly, if you have P of B given A also, from that also you can derive. That is P of A, you can write either like this or P of A into P of B given A. when they are independent, b given a will become p of b. Similarly here, if they are independent, if a and b are independent, p of a given b will become p of a only. Therefore, it will become p of a into p of b. So this is important. When they are independent events, then you can write like p of a intersection b is equal to p of a into p of b. In general, you cannot write like that. Okay. Then next is Bayes rule. One definite question for even for 5 or 7 marks, you can expect Bayes rule. Okay, so 4 questions will be there, no? That is, the 2 questions almost you can expect from first unit. So totally there are 8 questions, right? So minimum 1 or 2 questions you can expect from first unit itself. So because conditional probability is important, product rule is important, Bayes rule is important. One definite question from Bayes rule you can expect, because these kind of problems in Bayes rule, it is like VC problem we have solved, and from manufacturing problem, that is 3 machines will be manufacturing, from that defective items, those kind of problem. One definite question you can expect, either that VC problem or defect, because VC problem is also a standard question. Okay, either that VC problem you can expect, or one definite question from defective items. Okay, so 2-3 questions we have done using this, so please go through that, because it is very big, I am not doing now. Okay, so even the last year question, we have one question like that, that 30%, 30% and 40% of total product, 2%, 3% and 4% are defective from 3 machines. And if one is selected from the defective items, what it can come from, either can come from machine 1 or machine 2 or machine 3, like that. Okay, so please go through those kind of problems, 1 or 2, practice them. Definitely you can expect one question from Bayes rule. Okay, for 5 marks minimum. Then definitions of random variables. In random variables, we have 2. One is discrete and continuous. Always remember, for discrete, this mean variance and all, it will be there in the second unit. Okay. So just definitions, discrete and continuous random variables. What is the probability function, probability mass function? For discrete, we write sigma. Please remember these things. These are the different differences. Here we use sigma summation, and in if it is continuous, you will use integration. Okay. And here in discrete, we have probability mass function, and here probability density function, PDF. Here it is PMF and PDF. And here also probability function just means it is cumulative distribution function. Cumulative means up to that point you have to add. Okay, you have to add up to that point. X less than or probability of X less than or equal to A, that is cumulative. Here also probability of X less than or equal to A means what? Integral minus infinity to A. You have to find the integral of minus infinity to A. That will be the cumulative function. Cumulative means up to that point. Okay, probability function or cumulative function. That is, that can also be asked even for 2 marks. Okay. I will solve one problem from the previous year questions. And joint probability distribution is also there. Just go through that definitions. Joint probability definitions. Because without knowing joint probability definitions, you don't know. Actually, in your syllabus, you have statistical independence. Statistical independence. Without knowing that joint probability distribution, you cannot define this statistical independence. Okay, so you just go through the definitions, if possible practice, otherwise you just go through the definitions. Okay, that will be helpful anyway. So we'll do some problems which are there in the previous year questions, whichever is easy, that if I feel that you can do, I'm not doing those questions. Okay, remaining I'll do. One question is, if P of A is equal to, this is also simple only, but still, P of A is equal to 2 by 3 and P of B is equal to 1 by 5 And you are asked to prove that minus 2 by 15 less than or equal to P of A intersection B less than or equal to 1 by 5. It is actually minus 2 by 15. Okay. So, you know that P of, in two ways I will do this problem. Actually, first part I'll take it separately. Second part I'll take it separately. Okay. That is, first I'm going to prove that P of A intersection B is greater than or equal to minus 2 by 15. And P of A intersection B is less than or equal to 1 by 5. This part I'll explain. It is very simple. Actually, you know that if you have A and B, this is our A intersection B, right? So this will be definitely less than. This is a subset of B, right? Therefore, probability of A intersection B definitely will be less than or equal to probability of B, right? So what is probability of B is given 1 by 5. So probability of A intersection B is less than or equal to 1 by 5. This part is over. Now I want to prove that probability of A intersection B is greater than or equal to minus 2 by 15. For that, you know that P of A union B, any probability if you take, it is less than or equal to 1, right? It may be equal to up to 1 only you can have, right? What is P of A union B? Just now addition theorem we have seen, no? P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B less than or equal to 1, right? What is P of A? 2 by 3 plus 1 by 5 minus P of A intersection B is less than or equal to 1. That is, this if you take LCM here, 3 into 5, 15 and 10 plus 3. So 13 by 15 minus P of A intersection B is less than or equal to 1, right? Therefore, so 13 by 15 minus P of A intersection B is less than or equal to 1. You subtract minus 13 by 15 both the sides. So minus P of A intersection B is less than or equal to, or you can bring this P of A intersection B to this side and 1 to this side. So P of A intersection B is greater than or equal to 1 if it goes this side, 13 by 15 minus 1, which is minus 2 by 15, right? Now we have proved that minus 2 by 15 is less than or equal to P of A intersection B. This is equation number 1, or this you can write this as equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. So from 2 and 1, combining 1 and 2, 1 and 2 we get minus 2 by 15 less than or equal to P of A intersection B less than or equal to 1 by 5. This is what they asked. Yeah. And one more question. Let F of X is equal to 3X squared. These kind of questions also you can expect now. So 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1, right? P of f of x is equal to 3x squared. And be the probability density function of a continuous random variable. And determine A and B such that there are two parts. One is P of x less than or equal to A is equal to P of x greater than A. And the second part is P of x greater than B is 0.05. So, first part I'll do P of x greater than less than or equal to A. There are two methods. I'll do both. P of x less than or equal to A is equal to P of x greater than. So, by definition, you can write this. Where is it defined? The function is defined only from 0 to 1. Remember, here 0, 1. This side it is minus infinity. Here it is plus infinity. Okay. So, in this side, the function is not defined 0. Only here it is defined as 3x squared. And here 0. So, only in this 0 to 1 interval, it is defined as 3x squared. Okay. So, wherever you want. Otherwise, if it is less than 0 and more than 1, it is 0 only. The function is not defined. It is 0 otherwise. Okay. So, here P of x less than or equal to A means what? Integral minus infinity to plus A. 3x squared dx is equal to integral a to infinity 3x squared dx, right? Or here it is defined only from 0 to a, right? 0 to 1 only, no? So definitely a has to be in between 0 and 1. So 3x squared dx is equal to integral a to 1, 3x squared dx, right? So if you simplify here, you will be getting x cube, and x cube you have to substitute from 0 to a. X cube by 3 and 3, 3 will get cancelled. Similarly here, x cube from a to 1. So left hand side you will be getting a cube is equal to 1 minus a cube. That implies 2a cube is equal to 1, implies a cube is equal to 1 by 2, implies a is equal to 1 by 2 the whole power 1 by 3. Okay, this is first one. Second one, probability of x greater than b is 0.05, right? So integral b to infinity 3x squared dx is equal to 0.05. Or here again x cube from b to infinity is not there, b to 1 only it is there. So b to 1, because up to 1 only it is defined, okay. So x cube by 3 and 3, 3 will get cancelled. So 0.05. So 1 minus b cube, here upper limit 1 minus b cube is 0.05. Implies b cube is equal to 1 minus 0.05, which is 0.95. So b is equal to 0.95 the whole power 1 by 3, you can say. Otherwise, the same problem can be done like this also. See, p of first part is p of, this is Salitre, okay, the another method. So p of x less than or equal to a is p of equal to p of x greater than a. Whichever you feel easy, you do that. Okay. So p of x less than or equal to a. So you add this here also. P of x greater than a means you can write like this. You bring it to the left hand side. So 2 into p of x less than or equal to a is 1. So p of x less than or equal to a is 1 by 2. So what is p of x less than or equal to a? Integral again 0 to a only. Minus infinity to a, but of course here it is defined from 0 to 1 only. So 3x squared dx is equal to 1 by 2. Therefore x cube from 0 to a is equal to 1 by 2. That means a cube is 1 by 2. Therefore a is equal to 1 by 2 the whole power 1 by 3. Okay. Similarly for b, p of x greater than or equal to b, x greater than b is given as 0.05. I can write this as 1 minus p of x less than or equal to b as 0.05, right? So p of x less than or equal to b is 1 minus 0.05, which is 0.95. 0.05, you can write it as 1 by 20 also. Then it will become 19 by 20. Okay. So here p of x less than or equal to b means integral 0 to b 3x squared dx is equal to 0.95. Or x cube. Here you will be getting b cube is equal to 0.95. Therefore b is equal to 0.95 the whole power 1 by 3. Or you can write it as 19 by 20 in the whole power 1 by 3 also. So these are the questions you have to practice. Please practice these things. All the definitions are important. Discrete variable. Only here in the random variable, it is only discrete and continuous. Definitions are important. In the second unit, you will get mean, variance and all those things. Find the value of k, all those things. Okay. So please practice more problems. If you get any doubt, feel free to ask. Only one more day is there. Please practice well. And I'll try to complete all the 5 units by tomorrow. Okay. Maximum I'll try to upload one more today and remaining 3 by tomorrow. Thank you so much for listening and all the very best for your exams. Please prepare well and write well. Thank you so much.